I'm a little close to the camera right now. That's because today we are doing some close-up magic. Hey, what's going on? It's been a while since I've taught a magic trick on this channel, so I'm back here with another one. And as you might have seen in the performance, if there wasn't, I'll go over to the table and do it. But as you will see, there is a nice double reveal ending, and the spectator does pretty much all of the work. And there's no slides, super easy. And credit to this magic trick goes to John Railing. Also, sorry about the quality. It's kind of overcast and thundering and raining right now, so there's not as much sunlight entering the room. So let's get right on into it. Alright, so what I want you to do is alternately do one card, making two piles that are equal like that. And you can do however many you want. Alright, so now what I want you to do is, with each pile, do the exact same thing. And then you should have four piles at the end. Alright. So, we have these four piles here. I'm not gonna touch it, but I want you to turn over the top card of each pile. Congratulations, you got all the kings. But you know what beats kings in poker? The aces. So can you turn over the second card of each pile, please? I have concluded that performance is not really realistic, and it's kind of a natural. Part of that is me, and part of that is just the hand motions, and usually someone would actually talk, but I promise that if you actually perform this trick for someone new, they will react, and it will be a good reaction. Alright, so the cards I am using today are the Prism Black cards by Elephant Playing Cards. You can find them on Amazon. Alright, so first I'm going to show you a quick overview of what's going on, and then the tutorial, and then how to perform it. So you start the trick off by telling your spectator, okay, this is what I want you to do. I want you to deal down one card into two piles alternately, like so. And after you demonstrate that, you put those four cards on the bottom. And now it's their turn. They can deal however many cards they want, as long as they deal eight cards total minimum. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 is good. Just for the tutorial's sake, I'm gonna stop at 12. And then you can put the rest of the deck down. You don't need it anymore. And then they're gonna do the same thing with each individual pile. So they deal it alternately, one card into two different piles until they run out of cards. Same thing with this one. Now you can turn the top card over of each pile, and you see that they are the kings. But then you can keep going and say, oh, you got all four kings. Are you really good at poker? But guess what? You know what beats kings? The aces. Voila. Okay, so this trick is a setup card trick, and here's the setup. So you get all four kings and all four aces. Now you really don't have to use these cards, but if you want the poker reference, then you do the kings and the aces. And then you need four random cards. It doesn't matter what they are. So these four random cards go on the very top of the deck, and then the four kings go right after it, and then the four aces go right after them. And then putting this on the top of the deck, here's what we have. Four random cards, four kings, four aces. And then basically the rest of the trick is kind of self-working. Now at the first part, you saw that I demonstrated what to do, and then I put the cards at the bottom of the deck. So if you don't understand what I just said, I basically did this with four cards, so you got rid of those four random cards to demonstrate, and that just adds to the effect, and then you put them at the bottom. But if you don't want to do that, you can just show the spectator what to do and then keep them there, but it kind of adds just a little bit more to put them on bottom so they can deal their cards. As long as each pile have an equal number, like of cards in each pile, they don't have to be an even number, because even if the piles have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, this pile has seven, and so even if it's an odd number, when you divide it up, see, I didn't get another card there, it still works out. Now, because this is a setup card trick, they can't shuffle the deck. So what I like to do is just give it a few false cuts and say that I'm shuffling it for them, even though in reality I haven't changed the order at all. But if you hand them the cards, and after showing them what to do, if you hand them the cards and then they start shuffling it and then completely mess up the order, you just need to move on to a different trick. Or you can be like, hey, that's not what I told you to do. Now you gotta start over. Yeah, that's not fun. All right, so this was the tutorial for the Kings and Aces card trick, but obviously don't tell them that, because that will spoil the double reveal ending. And yeah, let's go on to the outro. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you like these magic trick tutorials, be sure to let me know, and I'll see you next time.